Hey everyone, so this is about how to draw a slice of cake. I'm using the Wacom Bamboo Fun Tablet CTS661 and Autodesk Sketchbook Pro 2011. So first we will start with drawing the frosting on the cake. So for that I'm using the line tool and the ellipse tool. So draw two lines and then by using the ellipse shape draw a cake shape here. Okay, and you want to make sure that all the edges, all the area is closed, then only you can fill that area. Okay, so once this shape of the frosting is completed, I will use the fill tool and then fill the edge will be a little bit darker on the pink side, and then select the little bit lighter on the top and on the side, so it shows a little bit light. It can differentiate between the edge and the top and the side. Next, we will draw a cake layer. So for that, I am using the little brown color for the top layer, and then again you can use the fill tool to fill that shape. Select the little bit darker brown color for the bottom cake portion. Okay, and again you can fill it with the same color. The middle section I will keep yellow for that, so select the yellow tool and then you can undo if you select the wrong color. So now that middle section is completed with the yellow fill. Next, I am using I will use the charcoal tool, and to give some some pigmentation on the cake layer and on the frosting. So you can select the size of the charcoal. Still a bit not correct, so you can go little bit smaller size. And currently this, the transparency of this layer is locked, so when you fill with the charcoal color, the charcoal won't go outside of the cake. It will only affect the area that is drawn right now. So as you can see, when I am filling up with all the, now when I'm using the charcoal on the cake layer, it is not going outside. You don't see that on the white portion, only on a brown section. Okay, so to do that, you have to select lock the transparency. Next, I will create the second layer, and on that one, I will draw the candle. So for that one, I will use the ellipse and line tools. So select the light brown color, and then draw the circle using the ellipse tool. I'm drawing a little bit bigger here so you can see properly, and then once it's completed, I will resize it and put on the top of the cake. Okay, so I use ellipse tool and line tool to draw this cylinder shape. For the flame, I will use the yellow color, and then once the flame is completed, you can fill with the yellow color. The middle section is a little bit darker, so I will use the orange color for the flame. Okay, and then I will create two stripes on this candle here. So this is kind of wax is melting a little bit, so that's for that effect. Okay, so for this stripe, I will use the red color to fill it up. Okay, and now you can resize your candle. according to the proportion with the cake. Now you can move that cake on the top of the, move that candle on a cake. We will lock these two layers, so we don't change anything on those two layers. The first layer is the cake and second is the candle, and now we're creating the third layer, and in the third layer we will create few gems like M&M candies. So when you draw the first, draw the oval shape and select the little bit lighter red color and fill on the top and darker on the bottom side. So this will kind of give you the 3D effect on it. And we will create the same M&M candy, so like gem candy for different colors like yellow and blue as well. Okay, next I will draw the same blue gem candy. Currently the transparency is locked, so I need to unlock that one. So you go in the and unlock the transparency, and then create the blue oval and fill up with the blue color. And again we will draw the yellow gem. So draw the oval, fill with the yellow color, and we follow the same pattern to give a 3D effect. Select the on the bottom of the blue gem, put the darker, and on the top put the lighter blue color. So this kind of gives the 3D effect. We do the same on the yellow gem. So darker yellow on the bottom section and lighter yellow on the top one. And then you can just copy and paste, and then we will place on the top of the cake. So just do the Ctrl C, Ctrl V to create duplicate how many gems you want to create. And next we select one by one and then place on top of the frosting layer of the cake. So once this gem layer is completed, we will lock that layer, and then we will create another layer. So this is the last layer, and that will be for the plate on which this cake is sitting. So this is kind of oval shape. I'm using the ellipse too, and then place the cake in the middle of this plate. So now cake is in the middle of the plate, and then I'm going to fill that plate with the light green color. I need to draw first oval shape first, and then I can fill it up. So once that oval shape is done, I will fill up with the light green color. And to give some depth to this this plate, we will select the darker green color and create the edges on that one, again using the ellipse tool. So brush tool will be better choice, and that will give some depth to this plate. So I think that's pretty much. Hopefully you like this video. If you like it, subscribe to my channel, and thanks for watching. Okay, bye.